Myasthenia gravis, or MG, is one of the most commonly encountered neurological conditions that arise as a result of a defective neuromuscular transmission. This is a short presentation covering the important aspects of MG. At the end of the lecture, you should be able to briefly describe the underlying pathophysiology of MG, learn to recognize its signs and symptoms, understand the principles of investigating and treating a patient with MG. You should also be able to consider differential diagnoses, which may give rise to similar presentations. The underlying pathophysiology in MG is a result of autoantibodies against the postsynaptic acetylcholine receptors. Acetylcholine is the neurotransmitter involved in neuromuscular transmission. Binding of the autoantibody to the acetylcholine receptors, as shown in the illustration, leads to increased receptor degradation and hence decreased transmission across the neuromuscular junction. MG has a prevalence of about 14 per 100,000 people in the United States. It can present at any age and tends to have a bimodal distribution with female predominance during the second and third decades of life, and subsequently male predominance in the 6 to 8 decades. Patients with MG may also have concurrent autoimmune conditions such as Graves' disease, rheumatoid arthritis, pernicious anemia, diabetes mellitus, etc. The main symptoms in MG are due to muscle weakness. In ocular MG, it only affects muscles of the eyelid causing ptosis, as well as weakness of the extraocular muscles causing diplopia. MG may also affect other muscles other than the eye, hence being termed as generalized MG. The hallmark of MG is the fluctuation of weakness, which may be readily apparent from the patient's history. From the physical examination, the most important sign is to demonstrate fatigable weakness. There will be no impairment of deep tendon reflexes and sensation is intact. Some patients with mild MG may have normal clinical examination whilst history suggests weakness. In these cases, it is important to rule out a neuromuscular transmission defect such as MG and try to fatigue the muscle groups with repetitive movement before assessing the power again. The ice pack and tensilon test can be performed at a bedside and can help with the clinical diagnosis of a neuromuscular junction disease. The ice pack test is performed by applying a cold ice pack onto the affected muscle group, such as the eyelid in a patient presenting with ptosis. After application of the ice pack for about 2 minutes, one should look out for reversal of weakness and fatigability as cold improves neuromuscular transmission. The tensilon test employs the use of intravenous adrenochrome, a choline esterase inhibitor, after which observation and repeat assessment of the affected muscles are carried out. Demonstration of the autoantibodies provides the laboratory diagnosis for MG. The anti-acetylcholine receptor antibodies are present in 88-94% of patients with generalized MG and about 50% of patients with ocular MG. Anti-muscle-specific kinase antibodies are present in about 38-50% of patients with generalized MG, while they are rarely found in patients with ocular MG. Electrophysiological evidence for MG can be obtained from repetitive nerve stimulation, showing decremental amplitudes of muscle action potential and single-fiber electromyography demonstrating jitter due to the variability of the action potentials generated. MG may be associated with thymoma, thus a CT scan of the chest should be performed. Symptomatic control in MG is with acetylcholinesterase inhibitors such as pyridostigmine. However, patients may need additional treatment in the form of immunosuppressants such as prednisolone or other steroid-sparing agents such as azathioprine or mycophenolate mofetil to maintain remissions of symptoms. In myasthenic crisis, where patients experience acute worsening, particularly affecting bulbar and respiratory muscle, airway protection and ventilation is vital. Treatment with plasmapheresis or IV immunoglobulin have been shown to improve outcome. In patients with thymoma found on CT chest, thymomectomy should be considered. Avoidance of precipitating factors is important. Various drugs may exacerbate MG, such as certain antibiotics and antiarrhythmic drugs. There are differential diagnoses which should be considered in patients presenting with symptoms and signs suggestive of MG. Lambert-Eaton myasthenic syndrome is a paraneoplastic syndrome characterized by diffuse weakness and autonomic dysfunction. The repetitive nerve stimulation and electromyography can help to differentiate this form of MG. Inflammatory myopathy is characterized by weakness and fatigue without sensory deficits. Electromyography and a serum creatine kinase level may help to draw the distinction. Botulism is a rare but serious illness caused by Clostridium botulinum bacteria. The bacteria may enter the body through wounds, or they may live in improperly canned or preserved food. It may cause symptoms and signs of weakness, including bulbar and respiratory muscles, mimicking MG crisis. We hope you have a better understanding of MG after listening to the VAP. Thank you for your attention. The illustrations are obtained with the kind permission from the following.